Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play New Super Luigi U. On the last episode, we did the airship and we finished up the rest of Frosty Glacier. And on this episode, we're going to be starting Soda Jungle. So, we got a lot of secret exits to find in this world, as you guys are all aware of. So, let's get started. First level, Soda Jungle, Giant Swing Along. Here we got some giant stuff going on. We come down here. There's nothing to spawn this time. So this level we have these giant swings. These were never introduced in Mario U until Rock Candy Mines. Whoa! Here we have to chuck that Koopa to the right, or to the left. And it's a little bit difficult, but it's not that hard because they're giant, so they have giant hitboxes. And from there we get along here. And all you have to do is punt this Koopa to the right, and in he goes. Boink. And then we just go through the pipe. So after exiting that area, we can instantly get this next coin by just ground pounding. Of course you have to be Super Luigi. So that's not very difficult. Come up here, grab this fire flower. It'll probably help a little bit. And even then, having an extra hit is always a little bit beneficial. Just swing along there, shoot the... Whoa, that Koopa takes an extra hit. Thought I was going to kill him, but then I didn't. So, you can either use that Koopa shell to get that coin, or I found, because I never used that Koopa shell on my first run through, you can actually do a really fine jump to the side and be able to grab the coin without falling in the water. You have to use your spin jump, but... It's not that hard. On to 5-2, Dancing Blocks, Poison Swamp. And of course, as you guys remember, this level does have a secret exit, but we'll be doing that one later. So on this level, we have these blocks that kind of dance around, if you will. It's not that hard to get through them, but it's, you know. So these blocks here are going to fall out of the water. And it's easy to just jump ahead a couple. If you jump ahead too many, then you'll miss the block. Like this! You know, if I would have done one more spin jump, I probably would have made it. Sad. Sad times, I tell ya. Okay. This time, let's make this jump real quick, because of course in here there's a mushroom. I don't know if that was in Mario, if this was something that was in Mario. Ugh. Oh, that was really close. I don't know if this is something that was in Mario U, but I noticed that if you grab a block and it's supposed to have a certain upgrade in it, like a mushroom or an upgraded thing, then you won't get it. So I don't know. So anyway, here we want to jump up real quick and do a ground pound down to here. Uh oh. When you hit the block, this P switch will appear. Hit that. And these blocks will start coming up from below, and then you can use that to get into this pipe. So, that's something that's not completely apparent right away. Whoops. But doing so gives you... Oh, I didn't have a running jump. Gives you the secret exit. And if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna eat a goldfish. I don't know about you guys, but goldfish crackers are my absolute favorite snack of all time. They're crunchy, they're cheesy, there's everything good about them. I love it. Alright, so going through this stage one more time, except this time we're just gonna quickly, whoa, run through. Like I said, just jump over a bunch of them. Jump on the question mark blocks. Come down. Oh no! Oh! Okay, I didn't expect that to happen. I jumped one too many forward. Or probably two too many by the time I landed. So I probably shouldn't have tried that. Or I waited too long. Another very distinct possibility. Either way, I didn't expect the block to tumble out from there so soon, so... Well... The home button on my Wii U just shook. I wonder what that means. Probably have a friend online or something. Alright, so I could just run and grab it. I don't think this Koopa shell will hit it. Oh yeah, it totally will. I've always just kind of run and grabbed it myself. So as you see, we have a coin there, and these are going to kind of dance around. So we just kind of not get hit there. Oh, that was really close. So of course when that happens, just run down here and grab that, and then get to safety. And of course hit the end of the flagpole. It's not a long level, but because of the blocks, the way they move back and forth, it's easy to die. Like, really easy. But, of course, if you time your jumps right, then there's no problem. Moving on to the other side. Got Heart of Bramble Woods, Soda Jungle 3. So this level has, of course, these stupid things in it. And this level is actually really fun. I do really like this level. Our first star coin is going to be right after this blue switch here. So what you want to do... Actually, that was really bad. I shouldn't have done that. Use the, Use the coin to make that appear, and then just kind of go ahead and let it happen. This one is easy. Take one jump, two jump, and we're good. Don't get hit by the swing or the swinging legs as you go across, because that would just be unfortunate. This one here, we're gonna kind of go up like this. Well, but we have to get underneath here anyway, so just watch out for the legs. They kind of swing up, and then of course it's nice and easy to do it once you get on the other side. This one we're just going to jump over. As long as you're at the top of your jump when he's moving, then it should be okay. And that one, just, you know, make sure you hit the center. Because if you hit the legs, they're oh so spiky legs, then you just die. And dying is bad. Alright, so we're going to go down and do the castle. I mean the fortress. Stone Snake Tower, and we all know how we love stone snakes so much. So, here on the stone... Here on the stone snake tower, we have these things running after us too, which isn't so bad. What you want to do for this first one is just kind of... Whoa. Oh, there we go. Make sure you grab this acorn shroom, because it's really handy to have it. I don't know if I will keep it for very long, but I can always try. This one here, just jump for it when there's an open spot and duck to dodge the things, because, well, you know, it's good too. Alright. So, this one... actually takes a little bit of jumping too. Where we want to go is down there. I don't know if we can do this without the acorn shroom, but I'm pretty sure there's one up here. Yeah, there we go. So what you want to do here is just kind of sidle down and then come over here and fly up. And then up here there's the star coin and a bit of a hidden area which just has coins in it. So get the coins, go up here, and then we're done. And get in there and give me my seconds. Because I'm pretty sure I can beat this boss in 18 seconds. But you never know. What are you gonna do to him this time? I think this is a make big. Yep, there we go. He's big. So he's just gonna jump and fail, and we're gonna jump on him. And it's business as usual. There isn't anything new about this one. There we go. The one where he gets wings is pretty much the same. I mean, you have the jump like you do in a... I mean, your jump is better because you're Luigi, right? But it's not that bad. But we'll see when we get to it. I think that's in Rock Candy Mines. Alright, so after the fortress, it's time to head down and enter the woods into my favorite level in the world, the Boo House. Oh, this level, I tell ya. Not a big fan of this Boo House. Or maybe I am. I don't remember which boo house this is. Ah, yes, it's this one. Yeah, this one's actually pretty easy. This boo house is not difficult. So, first one, fly up. Or if you don't have the fly suit, just kind of get in there and then just, you know, jump in or to it. Because you can jump to it. Whoa, these boos kind of are, oh my goodness, a hidden block. Kaizo trap, I tell you. There's going to be this boo ring here that kind of jumps in and out kind of sporadically. This next star coin is above it, and then this one's kind of the same, but kind of not. So we're just going to make our way across here. Cool. The last, this one's kind of shadowed on the inside. We're going to jump inside. And here we have our exit. And then, of course, because we know this boo house has a secret exit, we haven't got it, so of course the last star coin is with it. And this star coin is actually a little bit difficult to get, because you have to make it to the end of the level with the acorn suit. So we're going to go through this one more time. And this time I'm actually going to walk you guys through it, because I'm pretty sure you get the acorn suit somewhere in this level. I don't remember. I've never failed to make it to the end of this level without the suit. So, oh, that kind of sucks, because I think that was it right there, because it just gave me a mushroom. Alright, so here we have these nasty boos. Here, of course, we have our trolley hidden block. Oh, that was unfortunate. Okay, I'm actually going to see if you can make this without using the squirrel suit, because I haven't tried that either. I've always kind of used the glide to its full potential, and of course I failed. And seeing that there's coins there, I don't think there is, so make it to the end of the level. The first block is going to have the mushroom in it, because that's just the way the game works. And then that next block will have the acorn suit. And again, I'll walk you through one more time, just because no one deserves to have to walk through something as scary as a boo house alone. Even though these boos are just so darn cute. But seriously, they are. I mean, look at their tongues hanging out. They just want to play. Okay. Oh, let's just do this nice and calmly. Now boo goes up. We're going to run over here. Dodge that one. I almost hit the hidden block. There we go. Okay, now we just have to make it through these boots. We're going to fly over this row, because it's nice and simple and easy. And I think we can fly over this one too. Yep. And I'm going to fly over this one as well. And then over here, hidden coin, there's a little picture of Luigi. And we've got our final jump of the level. Boink. And there we have it. The boo house is done. Not a fan of it, but this is an easier boo house, to be fair. And the vine grows all the way to the top cloud, and we get ding, World 5 Dash Beetle, which we're actually going to do right now. So, this level is pretty easy. Para Beetle Parade. The first coin in this level isn't until about halfway through the level, so we don't have to really worry about that. Our block is big to start. Oh, and we just get a 1-up from it. Nope! Oh, there we go. Alright, so this is a very simple level. Just, it's the same as the last one was as well. Just kind of go through the paratroopas. The one different thing about this level, as you just saw, is that some of the parabeetles have piranha plants on them, which is the scariest thing in the world, I know. But deal with it. First coin, uproot the prana. Whoa. Uproot the prana plant, and there we go. Bounce on the bullet bills, and we got our next star coin up there. If you fail, whoa. If you fail getting that one like that, oh, just ride the parabeetle up. Oh my goodness, I failed. We are not gonna accept that. Alright, last coin. Pretty simple. For this one, make sure you're on the right side of the bullet bill, because it really helps if you get a head start on this coin. Just kind of jump over this last prana plant, and then just sit tight on this big parabeetle until he glides you down into the coin. If you're too far to the left when that first one appears there, you won't quite have enough, you won't have enough speed to make it to the parabeetle and make it sink down fast enough before you can, what's the word, before it'll go low enough to actually grab the coin. So just make sure you get to the other, grab that second coin, and then make it over to the other side of the parabeetles before the bullet bill goes by. Of course, if you get hit, you can't grab the top of the flagpole because it showed you needed to kind of glide into it, but that was about it. The next episode of Let's Play New Super Luigi U, we're going to continue on our little trek through Soda Jungle. And we're going to go ahead and grab some of, well, we're not really grab, we're going to, well, yeah, I guess we're going to grab the coins in these other levels and then continue on. We'll probably finish up World 5 next episode, so hope to see you there. Bye.